and welcome back to Talk of the Town. I promised you a spotlight on some great local businesses. This is one that you won't forget. We're joined today by Paul Morrison with The Wood Cycle. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I'm excited to chat with you. There's so many interesting things, really beautiful pieces that you've worked on. We're talking today about urban wood and using trees that we lose from our urban landscape to enhance our homes and offices.
Right.
Now, when you talk about urban wood, what specifically does that mean to you?
Okay. Well, actually, what it is is a part of a national movement that really has deep Wisconsin roots, and it's taking trees from our own backyards, front yards, that are dead or dying or need to come down for some construction activity, and then using it in those same buildings, so milling the lumber, drying the lumber, and then returning it to the owners or nearby.
And what makes working with these types of trees or this kind of wood so important?
Well, first of all, it just makes sense, keeping it local. So it's that buy local economy, using local craftsmen and sawyers and such to do the work. And then the other aspect is that those are the trees we have connections with. We're familiar with them. We know the stories that go with them. And just that whole concept makes sense. And frankly, it just makes sense economically as well from a standpoint of using a local tree rather than going to some remote location or overseas to get your lumber.
I love this concept. Imagine a tree you used to climb as a kid in your backyard,
exactly,
becoming your family's dining room table or something,
right,
of that nature. What a great way to sort of connect with that piece of furniture or whatever,
exactly,
it might be in your home. What if you don't lose your own tree? Is that something that is necessary, do you feel, to really engage in this process?
Not really. What happens is your neighbors are losing trees when you're not. So obviously those most personal trees are the ones you actually know. But there's constantly trees. If you go through a neighborhood, any one of those trees could come down from, they all die from old age or from disease. And so sooner or later, there's going to be a tree from your neighborhood. And a lot of us that are involved in this movement track specifically where each tree comes from. So a lot of times, even if it's not your story, we know the local story that goes with that tree.
So obviously your business, The Wood Cycle, does this and creates, these pieces out of trees that are coming down. Are there, mm-hmm, others involved?
There is. And what's happened is there's an organization called Wisconsin Urban Wood that we're one of the founding members of. And it includes arborists as well as sawmill operators, wood workers, and just others that are interested in the topic. And it's growing both in Wisconsin as well as nationally.
I think what a lot of folks can really connect with right now is having some damage from flooding or, some of the storms that have happened this last month. How does somebody who might have a tree that needs to come down really connect
and
get started?
Yeah. So different types of storm events have different impacts on trees. So last year, for example, with the heavy rains we got followed by winds, a lot of cherry trees, tall, narrow tree with a canopy, the winds caught those and uprooted. This year, with the flooding, I would say more likely it's going to hurt oaks in the long term because they're very sensitive to moisture. So anything like that, we'll see those impacts over the years that follow. And basically what we do is just connect with someone like ourselves, Wisconsin Urban Wood, or The Wood Cycle, and we can work with you and try and figure out how to use that wood.
What if it's not weather or old age? What if it's emerald ash borer, which is, I learned, a bug that can really cause some damage?
Right.
Then what? Is that usable?
Right. The emerald ash borer, what it does is actually kills the tree on the outside layer by eating the living layer, the cambium of the tree. The wood inside that is still fine. So we are working a lot with the city right now on emerald ash borer trees coming from the parks and as well as from private owners, and the lumber is perfectly good, a beautiful wood.
This is such a fascinating topic. I think we've probably just scratched the surface. I encourage you to go to the website. It's really incredible what you're doing, and I want to bring up before we head to break that you have a book.
Yeah, it's called Tree to Table, and it's basically describing this whole movement of working with urban trees that's been growing, like I said, not only in Wisconsin, but nationally.
Hold it up a little bit higher so we can catch it on our camera.
Oops.
There you go.
There we
Perfect
go.
Angle. Yes, and you can go to the website and purchase this book. So I think it's an incredible way to just learn a little bit more.
Okay.
Thank you for sharing
Thank
some
you.
Of your story. Again, this is Paul Morrison with The Wood Cycle. You're watching Talk of the Town, and we'll be right back.